Hi, I'm George Pearson, and in this CorelDRAW video, we'll be looking at some of the new features here inside of CorelDRAW 2019. Okay, let's get to it. On the welcome screen, there's a What's New section, and this shows you most of what's new here inside of CorelDRAW 2019. First off, the biggest change is this one right here. This is a very important change. This is the new objects docker. And this is talking about this bit right over here. This is our objects docker. I'm going to show you what's happening in here. Let's go back to our getting started right here. And let's bring up our spaceship logo. As I do this, we see the different objects in here making up this particular image. Notice I have just one page. Page one, there's also always a master page. This includes things like your guides and the desktop and the document grid, things like that. So here's our page one. Everything is on just layer one right here. Let me open up layer one, and you can see the different objects down here on layer one. Now this is a lot cleaner than it used to be. The big difference though in here is that you can actually get a thumbnail view up here of what we're looking at. In other words, there's the Earth picture right there, pretty easy to see. Here's a kind of a blue curve. That's that curve right here, that circle right there. There's that spaceship. Notice that the spaceship is made up of several things, a little drop-down menu. There's the drop shadow, and there are different curves in here, different parts of the spaceship. There's the main body of the spaceship, for instance. There's the top fin, there's the bottom fin. We didn't used to have these icons, and this really makes this objects tool here, the objects docker, much more useful. That one little change is a huge change. Other little subtle changes in here, but this is a huge one. Across the top here, we have, you can look at our pages, layers, and objects. Just at the layers and objects kind of hides the pages in there, or just at the pages. You have different ways of looking at what's included in here, kind of help you focus your attention. And right over here are options for this particular docker. Also, if you right-click in here, little pop-up menu that gives you additional options for the docker right here. This is our context pop-up, and you'll see this in different places. Again, it's a right mouse click. Right now, I'm on this particular object right here. I can choose to break apart that shadow. I can group, cut, copy, delete, hide, and so forth. So this gives me options for this particular object. If I click outside here and then come over here and click on that Earth, just right-click here, and I get a different pop-up menu with options that work for that particular object. Click on the spaceship, again, different options based upon that particular object. So you have that right mouse click in here as well. Okay, so a lot of new stuff in here, including a new search box at the top. Okay, heading back over to the welcome screen. Notice the object docker is still open over here, even though we're on the welcome screen, but we're not looking at any particular object at this point. Back to what's new. Let me just click on the Objects tab and close that down. There are new non-destructive bitmap effects, so you can apply bitmap effects onto an object, and you can go back and change or adjust those without having to actually modify that. And this is, again, a brand new technique here, giving you non-destructive effects. There's a new tool in here if you're working with a pixel grid, which is something what you would do, let's say you're making graphics for the website. All web images are pixel-based images. So if you're working for a pixel grid, this allows you to easily match your artwork to that pixel grid, make it as accurate and as clean as possible. There are more what's new, so just kind of scroll down. There we go. There's a new CorelDRAW app. This is an online version of CorelDRAW. There's two versions of this, a free version which comes with your subscription to CorelDRAW with your copy of CorelDRAW. There also is a pro version, which is about $49 a year. But this gives you a lot of tools from CorelDRAW that you can use right online. You can even use this on your desktop, which is kind of interesting. You don't have to be online. It's kind of a minimized version of CorelDRAW. It's mostly here so that you can work on a project even though you're not at your main desktop computer. There are new templates, new ways of working with templates in here. And over here, they've added in PDF version X4 as a new option for PDF export. Now, X4 has some things like transparency and layers and stuff. Real interesting improvement on that one. Okay, coming down here, a few more things. Enhanced options workflow, a new find replace Docker, a new print merge. There's some more asset management in here. And of course, they've improved the performance. The program works a bit better and a bit faster. So quite a few new things in here. The one I'm most excited about, though, is the new Objects Docker. This is a much needed improvement. Giving us those thumbnails makes this a much, much better tool. And it's one of the tools you use all the time. We'll take a look at the new CorelDRAW.app. Now, this requires signing in, and this is just your standard CorelDRAW sign-in. So you already have that, your username and password for that. Just click on this, and we'll bring this up. Let me see if I can get this to fit our screen better. There we go. And it's launching right now. And there we are, we're inside of the CorelDRAW app. Notice I'm in a browser window here. This happens to be a Chrome browser window. Starts off with a new document file here. You can create a brand new document, width and height, or a specific kind of document from these different templates or options. Or you can look at your templates right here. There's your different new templates. You can also open from the cloud if you have anything up on the Corel Cloud. You can open from your computer. This will actually bring open a window on your computer. You can open it from there. Or you can open out a recent CorelDRAW project right here. Down below, there is a free 15-day trial for the pro version, which gives you additional features in here. Then just open up a recent one here, no recent file scale. I'll open up for my computer, and let me just grab something in here. This cup is frozen. This is pretty good. We'll bring this up. Now, all of the tools here basically work the same as the tools in the desktop version, so I'm not going to be going through all of this stuff. There just aren't as many tools, as you can see. Your basic layout is a little bit different. There's your object Docker left-hand side instead of the right-hand side. And libraries and symbols are up here. Right-hand side, we're looking at the page over here, our page layout, page setup. Across the top, these are where your tools are, your standard tools. You know, there's your view tool in here. Here's your some snap to options. There's your pick shape freehand. Tools are right in here. Here are basic shape tools right there. So instead of being on the left-hand side, they're right up in here. Here's kind of your tool dock, your tool panel right in there. See, here's the object I have open right there, compass rose. That's this particular object. Of course, your menu up here as well. So it's really just kind of a subset or a limited version of the basic CorelDRAW program. And again, all the icons stay the same. They work the same, ones that are available in here. And it's pretty easy to use, pretty straightforward. Once you have learned the regular program, it's real easy to come up here and use this one. Now, where this is useful is if you are away from your desktop and you need to work on a project, you can do it here. Just go ahead and just upload your project to the cloud. And once it's up there, then you can easily access it. Or if you want to show a work in progress to a client possibly, you can use this CorelDRAW.app to do that as well. So lots of potential operations or uses for this new CorelDRAW app. Once you know how to use the overall CorelDRAW program, aside from things being, you know, moved around a little bit, it works exactly the same as CorelDRAW, just limited on what your abilities are. So there you go, that's the new CorelDRAW app. And again, they have a pro version of this, costs about $49 a year, and has a lot more features, and is just closer to the desktop version. Okay, that's a fast look around then at what's new here in 2019. Thank you for watching my video. I hope you found it useful. If you like this video, click on the like button below to let others know. You can click the subscribe button so you don't miss any of my videos in the future. I'm frequently uploading new training videos. Don't forget to check out my website at howtogurus.com.